So bone grafting, you say it's changed over the years.
Yes, bone grafting has changed. We have amazing new technologies, new products into the market that are helping us to provide our patients with a much easier, straightforward, and faster clinical outcomes. We have today regenerative products, growth factors coming from patients or from bottles that we can buy that help us, when mixed with the proper bone graft techniques and materials that we have, provide a speedy recovery, pain-free, and a predictable outcome for our patients. So we can go place our implants into healthy bone, good quality bone, only anywhere between 3 to 5 months after the grafting techniques.
So the days of all the big bone graft procedures for dental implants,
yes,
kind of doesn't exist anymore?
It's less
than the hip?
Absolutely, absolutely. We don't do any of those techniques and these procedures anymore. Those heavy duty hip harvests are just basically obsolete today. There is no reason today for any oral surgeon or periodontist needing going to the hip to harvest tissues.
Now, for people that have like really limited bone, you have special implants for these people.
Absolutely. So there is basically techniques that we have that are called the zygomatic dental implants and the pterygoid dental implants that are used to get anchor outside the mouth. So we're going and getting those implants attached to the cheekbones or to the back of the mouth where your wisdom teeth used to be.
Okay.
So we're not actually using the jawbone, but we're going a little bit beyond that and anchoring to the...
It's safe and effective?
It's very safe. It's very effective. And actually, it's super effective because these techniques allowed us to provide our patients with a transition from dentures to fixed teeth, permanent teeth, instantly, bypassing all the cost, all the time, all the energy that you have to put into the grafting techniques and go straight from no teeth to teeth.